Søren Kierkegaard was a philosopher and theologian that lived in Denmark about 1.5 centuries ago. In one of his books, there is a story about a king who fell in love with a peasant girl. The king knew that it was impossible for him to marry the girl. Kings never married peasants. They always married royalty. But this king was so powerful that he could marry this girl and get away with it. But another thought sparked in his mind. If he married the peasant girl and stayed king, that would always be something missing in their relationship. Because he was the king, he believed that she might admire, respect him, and never really love him. The gap between them would be too great. She would always be conscious of the fact that he was royalty and she a mere lowly peasant girl. So the king came up with a plan. He decided that he would resign his kingship and become a loyal peasant himself, then to offer his love to her as one lowly peasant to another. Nice idea. But the king eventually realized that regardless of how noble this might be, it could backfire. He would lose not only his throne, but the girl as well. She might reject him, especially if she thought him foolish for doing such a reckless thing like giving up his throne and the benefits that go along with this being king. So, what should he do? The king finally decided that he loved the peasant girl so much that he would risk everything to make true love between them possible. Kierkegaard, the philosopher, never told how the story ended. He never told whether the girl accepted King's love or rejected it. He never told whether they got married and lived happily after that. Probably reason for not telling how the story ended might be because that is not the point of the story. The point of the story is the king's love for this peasant, the poor girl, and the readiness to give up everything for that great love. Isn't that a great story? Today we reflect upon another great love story ever written and told in the history, which also has no conclusion. It is ever continuing love story of God for fallen humanity. Here too, the point is God's unconditional love for us all. And this love is expressed in the person of Jesus. Second reading gives a kind of description about this love of God. It just says, God is love. John chapter 3, verse 16 also explains it in a better way. Today Jesus is before us with a proposal. As the Father loves me, so I love you. Remain in my love. His love for his disciples was so great. Jesus did not have to express it in words. but still he did it. At the Last Supper, Jesus at the table pours down fully himself. He expresses his love for his disciples and whole humanity. What is my expression of love towards my beloved? How do I express my love? Love has two kinds of expression. First one is in words, second one is in deeds. Living those words. When I say I love you, it also means that I am ready to do anything for you, for that love. Love becomes complete only when words are backed up by action. Jesus' words were backed up by his actions for us. Do mine. What is my expression of love? Jesus clarifies the second of his two commandments, summary of the Torah's Ten Commandments. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. As one short sentence, love one another. With added specific and intimidating parameter, as I have loved you. Love one another as I have loved you means selfless, sacrificial, forgiving, and serving love. It is not the feel-good, self-indulgent love that TV commercials push, but it is a selfless, self-giving love. The kind of love that God has shown for us, the kind of love that led Jesus to the cross. According to Dr. Murray Watson, love one another as I have loved you, the Greek adverb as can be understood here in two but related ways. It can mean love one another in the same way as I have loved you. It could also mean love one another since I have loved you. The same way and since I have loved you. So, dear friends, Jesus is our model and motivation. If we are conscious of just how much Jesus has showered his love upon us, that shows us we in turn need to love one another and we need to love by that example. Jesus is both inspiration and our role model. Certain points that we can draw from today's liturgy are, first, love is mutual. Love is mutual and not partial. Love cannot be one-sided. I just explained to you in the story when I started the homily. It's not one-sided, it is both-sided, it is mutual, and also we need to be ready to love anyone. When I love someone, I expect also that person to love me back, mutual. Jesus says, I love you, and then he adds to it, saying, remain in my love. I love you. Are you ready to remain in my love? That's the question Jesus puts before us. Second, love is commitment. I live by what I say. I live by the promises I make. Our words of commitment to each other does not change according to time and situation. Therefore, Jesus says, there is no greater love than to give one's life for one's friends. It is commitment to the extent of laying down everything. Love doesn't hold back anything. Third, love is all about giving. Joy of complete giving. I can't end this homily without saying something about the wonderful celebration that we are having across the world today as we celebrate Mother's Day, another great love story that most of us can write pages and pages about this love story. We learn from our mothers the greatest example of giving. Giving from birth till they say goodbye to this world. Mothers are selfless givers. It is also said about every mother that God could not be present at all the time everywhere. So he created mothers. So the quality of complete giving probably springs directly from God. This complete giving, we also see in our Mother of God, another great example. Let us take time today to acknowledge the sacrifices, the pains a mother goes through in bearing and bringing up children. Let us acknowledge. Let us give them love and not pain. What is my expression of love? To my religion, to my family members, and to my friends. What is my expression of love? Abide in the love of Jesus to love unconditionally. Amen.